In this video, we'll discuss the efficiencies as we move matter and energy through ecosystems. Imagine a flock of fluffy sheep grazing in a field. These sheep won't eat all of the grass. Even if they eat some of each piece of grass, which they won't, there still will be some of the roots and the stubble of the grass remaining. So when we talk about consumption efficiency, we're referring to how much of the plants are consumed or ingested by the sheep. So P sub P in this equation refers to the total amount of grass in the field, and then I sub H refers to the amount of the grass that's ingested by the sheep, and the H refers to herbivore in this case. So if you want to think of a way to remember it, H is herbivore. When we talk about assimilation efficiency, we may do just a little bit less imagining. When an animal takes in food, it digests or breaks down the food into small molecules. These small molecules are then absorbed by the cells in a process called absorption, and that food becomes part of the cell. This is called assimilation. Some of the food does not get fully digested and then assimilated into the cells. This food is excreted or egested. And another word for that would be simply some of the food gets pooped out and doesn't get assimilated into the cells. So the assimilation efficiency describes how much of the food is broken down and assimilated into the animal's cells as compared to the amount that the sheep or other herbivore ate or ingested. Next, we will talk about production efficiency, or PE. So in this equation, PE equals P sub H over A sub H, where P sub H refers to the production of biomass of the herbivore, and A sub H refers to the amount of food assimilated by the herbivore. So let's imagine our sheep. The sheep, when it assimilates the food, some of the energy from the food goes to power the sheep. So the sheep needs to move around. It may need to evade a predator. It may just want to walk to a new patch of grass where it will continue grazing. It might need to go get a drink of water, or it may simply want to stroll over to visit a neighbor and, you know, converse in its own sheep way. So sheep move around. They also need energy to keep themselves warm, so they may be burning up some of the energy in their cells to create heat so that they can keep themselves warm. So they're burning up a lot of energy from the food that they eat. The remaining food that gets assimilated is then used for growth. So the sheep can take that food that's in its cells and use it to build up new biomass, and that allows the sheep to get bigger. So it's either going to grow new hooves or tissue or flesh or fluffy wool, or if it's a mama sheep, it may be growing a new baby sheep inside of it. So that's all increasing the biomass of the sheep. So generally, a sheep farmer wants more sheep biomass at the end of each season in terms of both size of the sheep and in terms of the number of sheep. And this indicates that they have a healthy flock. So this increase in biomass of herbivore is known as production, P sub H. So if we put all of these different efficiencies together, we get the trophic efficiency. And so let's go back to imagining our flock of sheep in a green field. Over the course of a year, a sheep farmer wants to grow new sheep from babies to adults and produce a lot of wool to sell. So the farmer wants to increase his biomass of sheep. That's that P sub H variable. So production of herbivores. In this beautiful green field, the sheep will eat some of the grass that's present, but not all of it. And so the total amount of grass that grows and would be available for the sheep to consume is P sub P. So this equation, You have trophic efficiency equals the production of herbivore biomass, P sub H, over or compared to the total amount of biomass of the plants available for consumption. And so this tells you how much biomass of sheep is created compared to the biomass of plants available for them to consume. So another way to look at this would be if we look at the different types of efficiencies. The trophic efficiency is a product of those other three efficiencies that we discussed. So trophic efficiency equals consumption efficiency times the assimilation efficiency times the production efficiency. So if you look at each efficiency and what they are, consumption efficiency is I sub H over P sub P, and we multiply that by assimilation efficiency, which is A sub H over I sub H. And you can see then that the I sub H's cancel out, so you're just left with the A sub H and the P sub P. Then we multiply that by P sub H over A sub H. That's the production efficiency. So then when we do that, we cancel out that A sub H. So that leaves us only with P sub H over P sub P, so production of herbivore over the production of plants. Let's discuss these efficiencies now in terms of some more concrete example calculations. So let's talk about some of the given variables that we know. So imagine a grassy field. In the grassy field, you have a lot of grass growing, and that amount of grass is equivalent to 45 gigajoules per year per hectare of grass, and that's our P sub P. So I want to talk first about what this variable gigajoules per year per hectare means, so we can get past that and then just move on to the example. So gigajoule is a measure of energy, and then they're looking at how much energy is harnessed by the sun into that grass, or how much energy is equivalent to the amount of grass that's in that field. So you're looking at amount of energy that was produced or harnessed in a given year in a given hectare, which is a surface area. Okay, so this is just looking at how much grass was produced, and they're putting on it a unit of energy. So we're going to use that same unit for all of the variables, but I don't want it to worry you. Just remember they're all the same unit of energy. So then in this hypothetical field, the sheep consumed 20 gigajoules per year per hectare of energy, and they left 25 remaining in the field that they just didn't consume. Of the 20 that they consumed, they pooped out 15 gigajoules per year per hectare. So this was not assimilated into the sheep, it was just pooped out. At the end of the season, when the total mass of sheep in the field was measured, they found that it was equivalent to 2 gigajoules per year per hectare. So of the grass that was eaten, most of it did not get turned into sheep biomass. So from these numbers, we can calculate a lot of things. We're going to calculate trophic efficiency, production efficiency, and assimilation efficiency as examples. Okay, first we will tackle assimilation efficiency. So with assimilation, remember that assimilation is the amount that's ingested minus the amount that's egested or pooped out. So they ingest or eat 20 gigajoules per year per hectare of the grass, and they pooped out 15 of that. So they egested it without assimilating it into their cells. So they only assimilated 5 gigajoules per year per hectare of energy. And so if we plug that into the equations, AE, assimilation efficiency, equals A sub H, which is 5, that's how much of the energy was assimilated compared to I sub H, the amount that was ingested. So that means their assimilation efficiency was 0.25 or 25% efficient. Next, we'll move on to production efficiency. And again, you have to know that A sub H number, so how much was assimilated by the sheep or the herbivore, and that was 5, we talked about in our last slide. So we know 5 was assimilated, and then we were told in the numbers at the beginning that 2 gigajoules per year per hectare was produced. That's how much biomass of sheep was produced. So the production efficiency is looking at how much biomass was produced compared to the amount that was actually assimilated into the cells of the sheep. So the rest, of course, was used to move the sheep around and keep it warm. So the production efficiency, the amount that actually went into biomass production was 2 out of 5 or 0.40 or 40% efficiency. And then the final calculation is the trophic efficiency. And so this is looking at what is the efficiency of the ecosystem overall. And this one is surprisingly simple to calculate because you were actually given these two values. So you were given the production of the herbivore, how much sheep biomass was produced over the course of the year, and you were also given the production of plants, how much plant energy was produced over the course of the year. So we just divide 2 by 45, and that tells us that the overall trophic efficiency was 0.044 or about 4.4% efficiency.